Since still there are no antiviral medicines and vaccines to control COVID-19, it is suggested by physicians that prevention is far better than cure, and the best way in this regard is to maintain normal intake and blood levels of vitamin D and vitamin C. Well, today we will discuss the biochemical principles involved in the roles of vitamin D and vitamin C in prevention of COVID-19 and also appropriate measures to maintain normal levels of vitamin D and vitamin C in the body. Sources of vitamin D and vitamin C I have shown on the left hand side. These are easily available at affordable cost, and managing normal levels of vitamin D and vitamin C is very easy for normal individuals. I welcome you all on my stage, and the complete version of this video is available on Praful Gorkar educational channel on YouTube. Let us consider vitamin D first. The recommended daily allowance, that is RDA, of vitamin D is 400 international units or 10 micrograms. The best way to get a daily requirement of vitamin D is to spend at least 15 minutes in morning or sunlight, and face, arms and hands should get exposed to sunlight. Skin epidermal cells contain 7-3-hydrocholesterol. It is synthesized by epidermal cells from cholesterol molecules which are synthesized by epidermal cells of the body. Refer to left hand side. When sunlight, ultraviolet light, strikes skin, 7-dehydrocholesterol gets converted into vitamin D3. Vitamin D3 then first gets hydroxylated in liver to 25-hydroxy vitamin D3, and then in kidneys it is converted to 1,25-dihydroxy D3, that is calcitriol, the active form of vitamin D, which then binds with specific site on various cell DNAs and carry out its functions like a hormone. Then vitamin D2 can be obtained from plant sources like mushrooms, and vitamin D from foods like milk, eggs, fish, yogurt and cod liver oil. 100 ml milk provides 10% of daily requirement of vitamin D, 1 egg about 5%, 100 gram yogurt about 15%, 100 gram salmon about 66%, and 100 grams of mushrooms about 15%, and cod liver oil 5 ml about 55% of daily requirement of vitamin D. Vitamins D2 and D3 present in food are ultimately converted to calcitriol, the active form of vitamin D, as I explained earlier. Calcitriol, after absorption in the intestine, gets circulated to various cells of the body which express vitamin D receptors and perform endocrine functions. The notable function of calcitriol in the maintenance of normal calcium and inorganic phosphorus metabolism is well known, which makes the bones and teeth healthy and strong. However, today we will consider endocrine, paracrine and autocrine functions of calcitriol, which are very important to increase strength of immune system and which ultimately protect everyone from viral and other microbial infections. Most important components of innate immune system, that means macrophages, T lymphocytes, dendritic cells and natural killer cells, express vitamin D receptors. When calcitriol binds to these receptors by autocrine, paracrine and endocrine effects of vitamin D, immune cells secrete anti-inflammatory interleukins IL-4, IL-6, IL-10 etc. which bind pro-inflammatory interleukin receptors IL-1 and reduce infection-induced inflammation. Similarly, by the effects of calcitriol, Th2 helper cells become more active, which promote activation of B cells to secrete antibodies and decrease activities of Th1 helper cells, which promote inflammatory reactions in infections. By the action of calcitriol, cytotoxic lymphocytes secrete specific proteins, performance and granzymes attack invading microorganisms such as viruses and bacteria, and these create holes in their specific structures and destroy them. Well, references placed on the left hand side indicate role of vitamin D in prevention of an individual from various infections, particularly respiratory tract infections like COVID-19, SARS, MERS and influenza. Normal blood level of calcitriol, that is vitamin D, of a normal individual should be about 30 nanogram per ml. Values less than 30 nanogram per ml indicate vitamin D deficiency, and these individuals may suffer from fatigue, mood changes, muscle and joint pain. Hence, as I said earlier, since antiviral medicines and vaccines on COVID-19 are still not available as of till August 2020, the best way to prevent from this pandemic is to maintain normal vitamin D level of an individual by appropriate diet. Well, now let us consider beneficial effects of vitamin C, which is a water-soluble vitamin, unlike vitamin D, which is an oil-soluble vitamin. These are the various sources of vitamin C, and daily recommended allowance RDA of vitamin C for adults is 60 to 70 mg per day. This can be obtained by various food sources, as I have shown on the left hand side. For example, 1 cup of orange juice gives about 55 mg vitamin C. Lemon juice 1 cup gives about 53 mg. 1 normal dish containing 100 gram papaya about 60 mg, 100 gram potato about 20 gram, and 100 gram tomato gives about 14 mg vitamin C. Vitamin C plays very important role in the normal synthesis of protein collagen, which is a main component of connective tissue of skin, bone, cartilage, nails, hair, respiratory tract and lungs. For healthy formation of collagen, the amino acids prolin and lysine are hydroxylated by enzymes, and for this hydroxylation, vitamin C play very important role as a coenzyme. In the deficiency of vitamin C, poor formation of collagen leads to various diseases like scurvy, which leads to bleeding of gums, and other related conditions are easy bruising, poor wound healing, red spots on the skin, and painful and swollen joints. Now let us discuss the beneficial effects of vitamin C in prevention of microbial diseases, particularly diseases related to respiratory tract and lungs caused by viruses. A very important property of vitamin C is it facilitates good absorption of iron in the intestine, and vitamin C also plays a very important role in maturation of red blood cells, with good hemoglobin level, any individual can fight infectious conditions very well due to good supply of oxygen to cells by normal hemoglobin. And then good supply of iron leads to increase in iron carrying protein transferrin, which stimulates macrophages and T lymphocytes to fight microorganisms very well. See the figure on the left hand side, it indicates production of high percentage of ROS, that is reactive oxygen species, in microbial infections which ultimately destroy normal cells. Well, you have heard about cytokine storms, right? So those storms can be prevented, and its intensity can be reduced by vitamin C. And vitamin C has very strong antioxidant property, and it neutralizes damaging effects of reactive oxygen species very well. Refer to the figure on the left hand side to understand these effects. Moreover, healthy collagen formation due to good supply of vitamin C resists attacks of microorganisms very well. And that is the reason why I made a statement at the beginning of this video that presently, when antiviral drugs and vaccines are not available by the end of August 2020, the best way to prevent COVID-19 is by maintaining good levels of vitamin D and vitamin C. Since diet usually contains adequate vitamin C, blood tests are not required to see the blood levels of vitamin C of any individual, unless an individual suffers from genetic defect which prevents hydroxylation of amino acids, as I mentioned earlier, and then normal collagen formation will not take place. I hope you like this video. Next time I will get you another interesting video on this great subject, medical biochemistry principles and practice. Refer to our books for more information. Kindly subscribe and share our YouTube videos and hit bell button so that you will get idea about our upcoming videos. I wish you all a wonderful day. Take care, stay safe, goodbye.